Hi everybody, I'm Kimberly Turner from CookingKimberly.com, and tonight I'm going to show you how to cook Napa Jack's beer and oxtail stew. Now, I have about a kilogram of sliced oxtail. It's already cut into maybe, I don't know, inch and a half, maybe an inch and a quarter thickness. I have all different kinds of sizes and parts of it, so there you go. 1 kilogram's worth. On my stovetop, I have a large pot. It's been preheating with 1 to 2 tablespoons of olive oil. I think I used 1.5 tablespoons. Now I need to season these guys up before I sear them. We want to sear them because we want to get some beautiful caramelization on the outside of them. That's going to carry through the stew and flavor it as well. So that's going to go first. I have some carrots and some celery diced up. If you want to use onion and garlic for this recipe, which I am not, not everyone enjoys onion and garlic here, you certainly can do so. Please use 2 to 3 cloves of garlic and about 1 large onion, okay? Now this meat on the oxtail is rather tough. It needs to simmer for a good 1.5 to 3 hours. So if you don't have that much time to attend to dinner, don't start oxtail. Oxtail is something for maybe a Saturday or a Sunday or a night where you have an extended period of time to cook. So I'm going to season these guys up. My oil is nice and hot. That's what you want to make sure it's nice and hot before you get started. Tonight I'm going to start with a beautiful rub from Napa Jack's. This is Napa Jack's steak rub and it's specifically designed for beef. Well, oxtail is pretty darn close to the flavor of beef, maybe just a little bit richer. And I think it'll go perfectly with the steak rub. So I'm going to just quickly go ahead and season these guys up on both sides with a little bit of this seasoning. I'm going to kind of push it onto it because they are not all that wet, and that's okay. I don't want them wet because you're going into some oil, so you want to make sure that they are nice and dry. This is a gorgeous rub with a beautiful foundation of flavor. I'm going to tell you what's in here. There's salt, spices including chili pepper, a little bit of garlic, and some canola oil. There's also some other spices in here, spices that they don't want to tell you about that are beautiful and accompany beef wonderfully. Okay, so let's just push those spices in like a spice rub should be used. And flip these guys over and make sure they're nicely seasoned on both sides. We're also going to do a little bit more seasoning after this. This is just a preliminary seasoning just to get these guys seared up in the pan. Make sure you get both sides. I'll show you what it looks like in here. Lots of savory seasonings. They're really beautiful in here. Now I can see some dill seed for sure. I can see some chili flake. There might even be some sun-dried tomato real small in here. There's chilies. There's coriander. Oh, it's a beautiful, fragrant rub for sure. Certainly everything you'd want on a steak. All right, so I'm going to also season with some extra freshly ground black pepper just because we like our stuff really spicy. And I'm gonna get it with just a little bit of sea salt. Now these are gonna stew, so don't worry about releasing the juices from the meat with the salt. It's not really gonna matter in the grand scheme of things here in this instance. All right, into the hot oil they go. I've got sizzling going on, that's exactly what I want. Now these need to brown on all sides. So this is gonna take at least 10 minutes. Take your time. This is very important flavor development. It makes a big deal in your stew and you want a tasty stew, right, if you're going to all this effort. So make sure that they're nice and browned up. If you can't fit all of your oxtail in the pan flat on the bottom, then do them in batches. All right, these guys have been going for about 20 minutes, 25 minutes. And you need to let them go that long so that they get nice and brown. That's the entire point. Also, you want these gorgeous little black and charred bits on the bottom of your pot. That's gonna give you lots of flavor and we're gonna deal with that in a minute. So that's what these guys look like. They're nice and browned. And I'm just going to reserve them on the side, take them out of this pan for a moment while we handle some veggies. Oh, they look gorgeous. And the fragrance in this kitchen is something else. Boy, I just love making oxtail and I just love making stews. Tough meat is no problem once you add a little bit of water and give it a little bit of time. All right, so let me show you what I've got in the bottom. This is what I have all here, 1 kilogram's worth, right? In the bottom, we've got all these beautiful little charred bits. Love that, that's very important. Also, we have some of the rendered fat of the oxtail, and that's gonna be just extra flavor. Now, if you didn't know, vegetables are a really wonderful deglazer. So that's gonna help you get all that stuck on beautiful flavor is stuck at the bottom, it's gonna get off of the bottom of the pot. So in go the carrots, the hard veggies.
I have the celery as well as the leaves. And I'm going to add some beets. This is probably 2 or 3 medium-sized beets, diced. Now stir this all up. We're gonna soften these veggies slightly, as well as removing all that flavor off the bottom. Now is when you would add your onions, and you want to let these veggies go, not only till they're a little bit softened, but until your onions are translucent. I'm also gonna add 2 bay leaves, a little bit more freshly ground black pepper, maybe 1/2 teaspoon of dried thyme, or fresh. I'm gonna add 1/2 teaspoon of chili flakes. This is a gorgeous tailgating dish or a Sunday feast dish. I'm gonna add some mustard seeds, probably 1/2 teaspoon. Tiny bit of salt. 1 whole clove, as my mom would do. And the tiniest pinch of cinnamon. Tiny, tiny. I'm also gonna add 2 coriander seeds, maybe 12. And stir that all up until it's nice and soft. You could also add turnip, you could add celeriac to this or celery root. That would work beautifully as well. I'm also gonna be adding some sweet potato, but the sweet potato isn't gonna go in until the end. Sweet potato, the little chunks I'm going to be putting in, are only gonna take roughly 20 minutes to soften up. You don't wanna put sweet potato in at the beginning because they'll all just fall apart. It will thicken your soup, it'll be still tasty, but it probably won't be the right texture that you're looking for. So those guys are gonna go in at the very end, add a little bit, hint more sweetness, just like the beets are right now too. All right? I'm also gonna add 2 leaves of sage. I'm just gonna rub them together. Now, this is not an island style or Caribbean style oxtail. This is more of a, you know, more general rustic sort of wintry stew with oxtail. All right, these vegetables have softened some, and now it's time to add the liquids and the oxtail back. But before I do, I'm gonna add a little bit of alcohol just to help carry the flavor and enrichen the broth. So I'm gonna use about 1/2 can of the Waterloo Original Dark, about 250 milliliters or so, in it goes. Oxtail or beef tends to go very well with the flavors of beer, as well as a little bit of red wine. And I'm gonna add just a splash of red wine to this. You can use whatever kind of red wine you like. I'll probably add about 1/2 cup. Now don't worry about the alcohol content, that's all going to cook off and just leave you with the beautiful flavor. It's just going to enhance things. I'm also going to add 8 cups of beef broth, but before I do that, I'm going to add the oxtail back to the pan, to the pot. And into the pot goes my broth. All right, my pot is on about a medium-high heat, and I want to bring this up to a boil. So I'm gonna turn it up to on high, and as soon as it comes to a boil, I'm gonna turn it down to a simmer. This is gonna go between 1.5 hours to 3 hours. It needs to be tender and falling off of the bone or the cartilage, okay? So this is a labor of love, but you don't really have to do anything. I guess it's not much of a labor. It's just waiting, it's patience. So let it this run, let bring it up to a boil, turn it down to the simmer, and we'll see you in a few hours. Stir it intermittently in between, and if you see that it's reduced in water too much, add a little bit more water or broth as you desire. Okay, it's been just over 2 hours, and our oxtail is almost as tender as I want it to be. So a couple things are happening right now. I'm about to throw in some sweet potato. I had a large sweet potato, so I used 1/2 of it, maybe 3/4 of it. And I have a small dice, and that's going in. Those will probably take 15 minutes. I have a large sourdough loaf here that I'm just gonna put into the oven to heat on a low temperature. Now I've already used beets in this stew, so it already has a little bit of sweetness from there. I don't wanna actually overpower it. That's why I didn't use the whole sweet potato. I also have 2 cups of red kidney beans. It's roughly 1 large can. And that's gonna go at the very last minute, and it's just gonna heat through because these guys are already cooked. So make sure you're putting in cooked red kidney beans. So let that simmer for about 15 minutes. All right, these sweet potatoes are about 5 minutes from being done. Let's throw those beans in. Stir that through. And now's the time to do a taste test of the broth. Make sure that it's spicy enough, has enough pepper, if you want some garlic in there, if you want to add a little bit more of this awesome steak rub, you could do that. I did do a taste test and it is absolutely right on point. I didn't even have to add salt or anything else. What a lovely job we did seasoning up the meat to begin with, and then we used the same pot, so we had all those beautiful seasonings still in there. What a delicious, delicious stew. I can't wait to show you how we're gonna plate it. Now, I have some rice already made, and I'm just waiting for this to finish heating through and for my bread to finish heating as well. All right, I've cut my piece of fresh, crusty bread with butter. I have my rice in my bowl, and I'm going to serve up a couple nice slices of oxtail and some soup and veggies. Now look at this beautiful bowl of oxtail and now look at this gorgeous bowl of Napa Jack's beer and oxtail stew. You are gonna love this. Look at these giant pieces of oxtail. Now you'll need a fork and a spoon, but it's likely you will not need a knife because these guys, the meat is just falling off the bone, just like that. So you have this beautiful succulent meat that is so tender and juicy because it's been simmering for that long. It went 2.5 hours total tonight. Rich, hearty. The broth is full of flavor. If you serve it like we do, with rice in the bottom and you have the red beans, boy, that's always a good combination. Now some nice lean protein you've got going on here too. The sweet potatoes are done perfectly. They're not mushy or overcooked because we did it at the very last 20 minutes. The beans are still all together and intact. They haven't fallen apart and done the same thing as I was telling you about the sweet potatoes. They'll just fall apart. And that's not what you want. You want waterlogged beans. So let's try the beets and the carrots. We have this deep, dark, and delicious colored broth going on here. It is so rich because we did that beautiful job of caramelizing and getting a nice crust on the outside of our oxtail before we even started, okay? Oh, the oxtail is awesome. It's just falling right off the bone. Beautiful. Perfect with some crusty bread. You can dunk it in here, soak up all the liquid. Fantastic. What a beautiful foundation of flavor. It is beautifully savory. It's just the right saltiness. It's just the right spiciness. It is gorgeous. If you want to serve this with some fresh parsley on top, feel free to do that as a garnish. But I can't wait to eat tonight. I've been waiting for 3 hours. I love oxtail. So make sure you check out winecountrykitchens.com for this fantastic spice rub, as well as their whole line of spice rubs that come in this Napa Jack's line. They also have great mustards and barbecue sauces. They have lovely vinegars and things over there. What a beautiful place to shop online for foodie and gourmet things. Anyhow, that's how you do it, folks. That's how you cook Napa Jack's beer and oxtail stew. You are gonna love this. The men are gonna love this. You could do this for Super Bowl. It's great for tailgating. You know, if Father's Day wasn't so far in close to summer, this would be a beautiful thing for Father's Day as well. What a gorgeous soup, stew, whatever you want to call it. It's great for the weekend. Get the family together and have oxtail. Why not? Sounds great to me. Now, that's it. Follow me on Twitter at Cooking with Kim E with the capital E. Like the fan page at facebook.com/cookingwithKimberly. My shows are on ifood.tv/cookingwithKimberly, youtube.com/cookingwithKimberly. You can find my channel on Roku, Cooking with Kimberly, and I'm also syndicated on Apple TV. Come to my website at cookingwithkimberly.com and subscribe. Interact with us and let us know what's going down in your culinary world, right? Be a champion in your kitchen and eat deliciously. Bye. Thank you.